Hello students, greetings of the day. In last lecture, we just have discussed the C++ keywords. Okay. So in today's lecture, we are going to move towards our another topic, that is C++ data types. Okay. We all know that this C++ is an object-oriented programming language. And every programming language is going to receive an input from user, right? That input is going to be processed, and after the processing of that input, we are going to receive the output, right? And this all the things, all the activities are going to be carried out with the help of different type of instructions, right? And that collection of instructions are going to we know those collection of instruction as a program, right? So in our C++ programs, we are going to provide the inputs to that program. Those inputs are going to be processed, and we will receive the output with the help of our console script. So, whenever we are going to receive the inputs from a user or from that program, that inputs will be of different types. That input can be received with the different type. Right? So, we can receive that input as a number. We can receive that input as a character, we can receive an input as a string, or we can say that a bunch of characters, right, as a name, right? So depending on that, our C++ programming language have different types of data types. These inputs are going to be stored in our memory, right? And depending on the memory that is going to be used by those inputs, then different kind of operations can be performed on the input. Depending on that, we have defined different types of data types. Okay, so these data types are very important to receive the inputs from user or the inputs from your program. So what these data types are going to do? What is the work of these data types? With the help of these data types, they are going to specify the what kind of data will be stored in the computer. With the help of this data type, first of all, we are going to specify the how we are going to store that into our computer, or in which type, in which format we are going to store that information. So with the help of data types, we are going to specify how the data is going to be stored on our computer. So, depending on the data type, it is going to be decided that how our data is going to be stored on our computer. Also, with the help of this data types, we are also going to specify the what kind of operations are going to be performed. So, once we have decided the data type, depending on data type, we are going to allocate the memory for that variable or for that data, right? So with the help of this data type, we can also specify what we are going to specify, that what type of operations, are going to be executed data, right? There are different types we are having for these data types. Depending on the type, we can just perform some specific operations on that type of data. There are some building data types. We are having some building data types with us. There are some building data types. Building data types, which can be used as a keywords, which are actually a keywords. In the last lecture, we just have discussed keywords. And among those keywords, we are having some building data types in those keywords. What are those keywords? We can have an example. Just like integer, then we are having float, also character, and so on. There are different types of keywords that we can use as a data type, right? So depending on the type of that data, we are going to provide the memory in our computer system, right? So these are nothing but the data types. With the help of data types, we are going to specify the two things. In which format you are going to store our data in our computer system. That is, how data is going to be stored on our computer system. Then, with the help of data types, we are going to specify in what kind of operations that we are going to perform over that data. Right? That data types can be a building, right? Sometimes we can have a building data types. As an example, we can have integer, float, character. These are the data types that we can have, right? With the help of which we can store the information on computer's memory. Okay. Now, if you are okay with these data types, if you have understood these data types, we can move forward to the types that we can categorize the data types into. We can categorize the data types into three categories, right? We can store the information on computer. We can store the information on computer with the help of these data types. We can use data types to store certain kind of information on computer. But that can be stored with the help of different types, right? Different types of data types are there. So, what is the first type? The data type can be a primitive one. Okay, primitive data type is there. Primitive data type. The first one is there. You can also call it as a preliminary data type. Okay, or primary data type. You can call it as primary data types. Okay, you can call it as primary data. The second that we can have is derived data types. Derived data types. And the third one that we can have is user defined data types. Okay, means you can categorize these C++ data types into three categories. The first category is nothing but primary or primitive data type. The second one is derived data type, and the third one is that is user defined data type. Now in today's lecture, we are just going to discuss these three data types or three types of our data types. So let us start with the first one, the primitive or the primary data type. This kind of data types, the first primitive data type, these types or these primitive data types are built-in data types. Built-in data types. So, primitive data types are going to be defined by the system. These type of data types are already defined by the computer system or your programming language. The second thing that you can have with the primitive data type is it has fixed size. data types are going to have fixed size. We cannot change the size of this primitive data types. It is not possible. If we are having one data type of primitive that has been provided with some memory allocation, some byte of memory will be allocated with the help of that data type, and we cannot change that size. Okay, so the first thing that we can have with primitive data type, that is, these data types are built with built-in data types. Then these are having fixed size. We cannot change the size of such a kind of primitive data types. These types or these data types, are going to hold one information at a one time. It can hold only single character, or we can say that it can hold a single value. Such a kind of primitive data types are going to hold a single value at a time. Means if a variable you are having of type integer, okay, integer a is there, you are having 5 in that, right? Means at this stage you are having a integer data type which is having a value 5. Means at that memory location you just have stored 5. Now you cannot store another value at the same time when you are having 5 value. Means if you are going to execute another instruction integer a is equal to 6, at that time your 5 are going to be erased, and at that place the value 6 is going to be stored. Means the value is going to be replaced. Means what? It can hold a single value at a single time. You cannot store the multiple value at the same time at your primitive data types. Okay, by using the primitive data types. There are 5 primitive data types. There are 5 common primitive data types. 5 primitive data types. Okay. Generally, or in common, we are going to use only these 5 primitive data types. So, what are these primitive data types? The very first thing there is character. Then we can have integer. After integer, we can have float. After float, we are going to have double. And the last one there is void, or we can say that the null value. So these are the 5 primitive data types that we can use with the C++ programming language. The first is character, second is integer, third is float, then double, and the void. So these are the 5 primitive data types that we are having, or that we can use in our C++ programming. Now we are going to discuss all these primitive data types in detail in next lecture. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss the another 2 types that we are having with us. That is nothing but the second one that we are having is derived data types. Before that, we will quickly revise this primitive data type once again. The primitive data types are the data types which are built-in data types, which are already defined in your computer system by your programming language, which are having fixed size, then which holds a single value at a time. Primitive data types are going to hold a single value at a time. Then there are 5 primitive data types, and which are the character, integer, float, double, and void. You can use these 5 primitive data types which are defined by your system. Okay, so this is about the first type, that is primitive data type. The second type we are having is derived data types. derived data type. So what is this derived data type? As this name suggests, these data types are going to be derived with the help of another data types. The only data type that we have discussed before this derived data type is preliminary data type, or sorry, primary data type. Data types. So these derived data types are the data types which can be derived with the help of primary data types. Means to have such a kind of derived data types, we are going to use make use of primary data types. And what are those primary data types? We all know the primary data type is nothing but integer, character. Then we can also have float is there, double is there, also void is there. Whenever with the use of these primary data types, you are going to have the derived data types. Means in the derived data types, we can have different data types, and in those data types, we are just going to make use of this primitive data types. One of these primitive data types. So what are these? The definition is, these are the derived forms, these are the data types which are derived from primitive data type. What are the examples we see in primary data types, the five data types that we are having? Under these derived data types, we are also having another derived data types. The first is there, that is, as an example, we can say that array is there. We are also going to have the functions and pointers. So the arrays, functions and pointers are the examples of your derived data type. By making use of this primitive data type, we can create an array. By making use of this primary data types, primitive data types, we can initialize or we can define the functions. We can also define the pointers. We all know that what are the functions and what are the pointers. Basically, we all know that. So we will see the example of one derived data type of array. We all know that array is nothing but is a collection of your data, collection of data. If with the integer, in a one variable, you can store only one value. But if you want to store more than one value at that variable space, then you can have the array data. Right? How we can initialize this array? The example syntax is there. Okay, now if I want to store the five set of five values, set of five values at one variable, at that time what do I am going to do? Five values are of integer type. Okay, integer type, we can say that integer. So I can initialize the array, or I can have definition of array is integer k of 5 values. Okay, is equal to directly I can initialize this is a frequency syntax to have array of integer type. Right, so it is nothing but a derived data type array. Okay, I can also initialize the value as 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. This value will be initialized at this spaces. Okay. A of 0 is equal to 1, A of 1 is equal to 2, A of 2 is equal to 3, and so on. A of 4 is equal to 5. So on that memory location, we are going to store this value. Okay. Let us consider this is k, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Imagine that the matrix of 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So likewise, we can have derived data types in our C++ program. So the example is integer a of 5. The size is going to be changed, right? You can specify the size of your array, right? How much value do you want to store? Depending on that, the value of this array is going to be changed. Likewise, you can also have character name. Adding 10 bytes, okay? 10 bytes space, memory space. So this is nothing but the declaration of variable. The importance you can declare the variables like that. So this is derived data type. Okay, this is derived data type. The second C++ data type. Then we can have the third one is there. That is user defined data type. Okay, the third one is there. After derived, we can have user defined data type. User defined data type. User defined data types. Okay. So, as name suggests, these user defined data types are going to be defined by the user. These are defined by users. Okay. These are the data types which are defined by the users. Then, such a kind of user defined data type, the size of such kind of data types, then architecture, then the operations that are performed, such a type of data types are going to be decided by user itself. The user is going to decide what kind of operations are going to be executed on such a type of data type. Okay, it is the third type of data type, that is user defined data type, which is defined by the user. Size, architecture, then operations which are going to be performed on such a kind of data types are going to be decided by the user itself. Right? What are the examples? What are the examples of such a kind of user defined data types? The first that we can have is structure, then you can have union, you can have class. And we can also have the enum is there, right? So these are the user defined data types which can be used in our C++ data types. Okay, so this is the third type of our C++ data type, that is user defined data types, which is defined by the user, and all the operations, the size of that your user defined data type, then architecture of that data type, which is going to be specified or which is going to be decided by the user. The example that we are having is structure, union, class, and enum. The very common example that we are going to have of the user defined data type is nothing but class. In our C++ programming, in almost every program, we are going to use this class. User defined data type. Okay. So, this is all about our today's topic, that is C++ data type. Okay. So, in today's lecture, we are going to end with session. In next lecture, we will try to have the another topic with us. Okay. We will discuss that another topic in our next lecture. Okay. So, thank you very much. We will see you next lecture.